We're back with Bill Maher and Ryan Seacrest. They've been with us all the way. Joining us now, my good friend, Dr. Phil McGraw, the host of Daytime TV's Dr. Phil, and he'll soon appear on Ask Oprah's All-Stars on OWN. How do you feel? You're an all-star now.
Hey, listen, that's okay. If you're hanging with Oprah, that's good, right? I mean, that's fun. I'm looking very forward to that.
Thanks for coming by.
But this is about you. This isn't about me and what I'm doing. I got questions for you, man. How do you feel about all of this? Every one of us, because, you know, we do shows. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. Because all of us are going to be in a position where we say, okay,
goodbye.
That's it. We're too far into it. We're running out of something to say. Mm-hmm. And we'll be going home. So I'm really studying how you're handling this.
How am I doing?
With grace. I mean,
it's
really
mixed
interested.
Feelings. You know, I'm going on to other things. I'll be doing a lot of things. But, hey, this has been a third of my life.
No, a lot of grace. I'd like to pipe in and say my little tribute on that score. Wow. Because, I've seen in the short history, really, of American media, a few people who really commanded the affection of the whole nation because they always had dignity in what is sometimes a tawdry nation. I'm thinking of Steve Allen, Johnny Carson, you know, Walter Cronkite. For me, I mean, Johnny went off in 92,
yeah.
Right? For all that time, for me, that guy has been Larry King. You know, in a nation that is too many windbags and douchebags, this man was never windy or douchey. Excuse me on CNN.
Well, no, I know. And you guys know, because we all know Larry off camera as well as on, and you never like to be the center of attention. You ask short questions. He told me 10, 12 years ago, he said, if it's two sentences or more, if it's more than two sentences, you shouldn't ask the question. You need to work on it and think about it because it's about them. But, I mean,
Doctor,
you really have handled this with such grace.
I can't tell you how appreciative I am of your coming by. We're short on time, but I thank you so much. I love your presence.
Thank you so much.
More surprises to come. I don't know what they are, so stay here and we'll find out together. As you can see, the panel has increased with the wife and the kids, and we'll meet them in a minute. Anderson Cooper and I have been meeting via satellite Monday through Friday for about 5 years now. All good things come to an end, Anderson. And sorry, you can't be with us tonight.
Yeah, well, Larry, I'm not going to talk about what's on my program tonight, which is what I usually do with this program. I just want to use my brief time to say thank you. You've been a friend, a mentor to me all these years that I've been at CNN, and I truly cannot imagine this place without you. And if I can say something very personal for a moment, you and I had lunch once recently, and we both talked about our fathers and how we both lost our dads at a very young age. I think you were 9, I was 10. And we talked about how one really never gets over something like that. And I was just thinking about how proud your dad must be for all that you've accomplished in your career, and more importantly, in your life, being there for your boys, for your family, taking them to ball games, to school, and doing all the things that I know he would have wanted to do for you and that my dad would have wanted to do for me. And right before my dad died, he actually wrote a letter to me, and I just want to read you something that he said to me. He said, quote, "We must go rejoicing in the blessings of this world, chief of which is the mystery, the magic, the majesty, and the miracle that is life." And I think you, more than most people, have done just that. In your life and on your show, you've rejoiced in the blessings of this world, and you've brought us every night the mystery, the magic, the majesty, and the miracle that's life. So I just want to thank you, Larry. We love you here, and we look forward to all that you're going to do in the days ahead.
Thank you, Anderson. I'm really touched. Thank you so much. Bill Maher is going to tell us what's next, Bill.
Well, Larry, I know that you have a special relationship with a lot of cities in America, like Miami, where you started, and New York, L.A., Chicago. There's one guy who left his heart in San Francisco who's going to sing for you.
You're kidding.
I am not kidding.
I am not kidding.
All right. Thank you. Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a flower. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet. The best is yet to come. Thank you. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain a cup dry. Wait till your arms are right for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're rocked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum.
Tony Bennett.
Tony Bennett.
Wow.
Give Larry a beautiful standing ovation tonight. Come on, everybody. We love you.
How about them apples?
Thanks for all the great interviews you've given us through the years, Larry.
Thank you, Tony. I love you.
Tree of life, I just picked me a plum.
Tony Bennett, wow. Well, Sean, how do you feel?
I'm excited. I'm proud. I'm honored to be your wife and to have been with you on this journey, and excited that we're moving forward to new things.
How do you feel, Chance, on this historic evening? Chance is 11.
Well, I think I mostly feel happy for you, and I'm really happy because now you can be with me more, and probably I can see you a lot more. And but it's not like you're not even gonna like not be on here anymore.
Cause we're doing other things, right?
Yeah.
Including seeing you play baseball.
Yes.
And Cannon King, who is 10. First, Cannon does me. Do me.
Where's Sean? Get in the car. I'm too old for this. I've done this for 50 years.
How do you feel about this night?
I feel glad for you and for us. And I mean, it's not like it's not gonna like you can not be on the show anymore. You're gonna come back, and it's gonna be fun for us. Yeah, you're gonna do specials here, and you're gonna try to get on MLB Network also.
Baseball has to be something.
And if it doesn't work, we're gonna get you a paper route.
That's a good idea.
Because we gotta keep you out of the house just a little. Just a little.
How do you keep pressing?
Wait a minute.
You
can hang with me.
Dr. Phil, you wanna
analyze her, Phil? Well,
let's go to Dr. Phil.
Let's go to Dr. Phil.
We have met the talent here in the family. I mean, clearly, great job. I thought it was him, but with hair, shorter.
It's so special. It's so neat to see you guys. This moment together.
You enjoyed the night, Sean? What'd you think of this show?
What an amazing group of people. And
Wendy Walker and this incredible staff deserve a lot of credit. Wendy, I can't thank you enough for the job you did and for putting this all together. It was a total surprise to Bill Maher and Ryan Seacrest for coming over and doing it, Dr. Phil and all the people in New York. And Chance wants me to cry. I don't know why.
No, I said you're going to cry. I didn't say I wanted you, but you're going to.
That's John Boehner you're thinking of.
Congressman John Boehner.
Larry's like a rock.
Not true.
All right, I'm going to have some final comments in a minute, but would you like to just say something about anything you want to say as if you were me? Go ahead, do the show.
Anything? Impression of you?
Anything, yeah.
I'll be right back.
Stop doing your makeup.
This is the last show. We're going to be late.
All right. By the way, I want to thank the whole crew in New York as well, all the producers there, the control staff, the people in Washington, everyone associated. I'll have some last words, but you can throw it.
We'll be right back after this.